Have you ever been curious about the container presenter pattern in Angular? Today, I will tackle this topic and give you more insights about it with practical examples. Mixing concerns not only violates many principles in software development, but it makes understanding and maintaining your source code tedious. Using container presenter pattern helps you to organize your components into categories and clarify their responsibilities. Container components are smart components. They know how to get data from the state and the services. They communicate with their chilled components via inputs and outputs. Presentational components, on the other side, take care of rendering the UI and managing the interaction with users. But keep in mind that they should not be always dumped. If you notice a big amount of inputs and outputs in your components tree when you pass data between the container and its children, this is a sign that you need to inject services into your leaf components to ease this problem, which is known as bubbling events, and make the code design more maintainable. So what are the advantages of using the container presenter pattern? Well, it gives you the possibility to have clean code by splitting your components into smaller ones with separation of responsibilities between them. You will also get a better understanding of the workflow and the communication between your components. You can also instruct Angular to manage the subscription and unsubscription from observables by using the async pipe. And you will have a more ready infrastructure for using the on-push change detection. Since the new values emitted from observable and handled with the async pipe will have new references, which is optimal for dealing with the immutability issue. Let's see now an example, which is a case study of refactoring a component by using the container presenter pattern. So if I go back to my browser, here under the module scrum board, we have here our scrum board, which contains different lists, and in each list there is a bunch of cards. If I click on this one, I will get this dialog containing this card. I will go to the source code of this card and refactor it. So let's see how it looks like for the moment. Here I have the scrum board module, and here is my admin board component, and under card details I have my scrum card details component. When I look at the constructor, I see an injection of a service, of a form builder, change detector, and mat dialog, which gives me insight there is a mix of concerns here. So to start, let's create two folders, containers and presenter. So I need to move them here under details. Let's move my component to containers, and I will also duplicate it or copy paste it under presenters, but don't worry, we will clean it up. So let's see what selector I have here. Here I have scrum board card details. I will add the suffix container, and I will rename my files by adding containers. Okay, I need also to add container here in the name of my component. And I need to go to the module and add the container as well. Minus container, and here presenter. Okay, I have already my component in the declaration. Let's go back, and I need to have a look at the template. So here I have the form, which should be moved to the presenter. And here I have just an icon to close the dialog. So I will refactor or change the content of my presentation component by removing the outside wrapper, and I need to get this selector and call my presentation component here in my container. I need also to remove the service from the presentation or component. And let's see where is it used. So it is used in the onInit in order to get the ball data and the list of labels from it. So this means that I need to change board and labels to input. Okay, input. Let's copy paste it here. Sorry, I need just to change board to input because the list of labels will be retrieved from board. So here board will be an input. Let's go back to the container and add it here as an input. And here I will say, I need to go back. So it is this one. And okay, let's add port dollar equal, which is an observable. I think it's board type, and it would be, its value should be this one. I need to import the observable from XGS, and I need to delete this form builder from here. Also this on board, and let me clean it up. I do not need board. Okay. So we don't need this subscribe since the subscription and unsubscription is done here. But what I need is in fact to add the async pipe, which will manage the subscription and unsubscription. Okay, here I need to add the implementation of onChange and the implementation of the lifecycle hook ng onChange. Let me move it after ng onInit. Okay, and import simple changes. I have implemented this lifecycle hook because I need to listen to the change in changes in the board. Whenever there is a change in the board, I need to initialize labels. So changes board current value. So now I can get rid of this block. And we have here also, we are listening to this observable cards. So let's go back here and add card. Here I need to adjust the type. And just like board, I need to add card here as input. And go to the presentation component, delete these lines, and make card as an input. Let's move it here. Okay, we have also another subscription, which is a subscription to the value changes of card form. And whenever a value will be changed, we need to call the update card from the service. So whenever there is change in the card form, we need to call this and update card.emit, and this will be the argument. Let's add now update card as an output, update card, and it should be an event emitter. And let's go to this one and look for update card in the service. So this is the type that we need to add in the declaration of our event emitter. Let me do it this way. Okay, now I can add in the template here. They have to add an output or an event, which is update card. And whenever update card is emitted, I need to call on update card with event. So, and you know that to make this working, I have also to go to my container and add a new method called on update card. Let's add it here. We need to add these parameters, and whenever this is called, I need to call scramboard service dot update card with ID and card. So here everything is fine. Let's go back here. And so now I can remove this. Okay, there is something that is not quite correct. So I have to add here this dot board dot labels. So let's check now if we still need this unsubscribe ball. Yes, we need it because it is used here. Okay, but here in the container, maybe it is not needed anymore. So these lines should be removed since they are now in the presentational component. The card form is also in the presentational component. This one should be removed as well. No need for it. And what we have now? So we don't need this unsubscribe all. Let's remove it. I think we don't need also this method. It's not used now. It was used in the remove method. Struck by fn is also no more used. This one is not used as well. Let's remove it. Has label. Not needed. Card also and labels should be removed. And this label input and filtered labels, because we don't have them in the template of the container. So filter labels, no more needed. Toggle product tag also belongs to the presenter. Add label to card. Presenter logic, remove labels, presenter logic. This one is also not needed. So no need for the change detector ref injection. So let's clean up. No debounce time, no need for subject and take until enter. So let's add a void return value for this method and go back to the presenter, which needs more cleaning up. So I would like to have my input and output on the top. Let's move this one here and make some space between my attributes. Okay, let's check where is this mat dialog ref used. I think it's in the template. So it's used just in the presentational component, which means we don't need an injection of mat dialog ref in the container. Let's remove it. We have a much more cleaner container now. So let's go back to the presenter. Okay, let's have a look at the template of our presentational component. It looks fine, there is no error. We can try to build and run the app again. So let's check why we have this error. I haven't adjusted the template URL here. And let's check the presentational component. Here the name of the template is correct. Okay, another error. Let's adjust here the name of the component and its path. Okay, what we have again? Expected two arguments at quote one, and I need to adjust it here. So this is in fact the event, and its type it's like this. Let me add event.id and event.card. Oh, let's rename it to card data. This should have fixed the error. Okay, looks fine. Let's go to the browser and refresh it and make sure that we don't have errors here. So it looks fine. Let's change, for example, this title to something else in the presentational component. This is the title and card. Okay, the card and the title are adjusted without any regression in the functionality. So it's working. And let's compare our current source code with the previous source code. If I go to the module, you can see that I have just added the declaration of the new container component. This is the container, how it was here. And how it looks now. And this is our template. It's much more cleaner and smaller. Previously, we had 121 lines, and in the TypeScript component, we had 284 lines. Now we have just 25 lines. And the presentational component, it has no injection of services in it. This is its template. And what is really helpful to us is the management of the subscription and unsubscription to the board and card observables, which are coming from the services with this async pipe. And here how we did it.